Hi there, it's Mary from stampingmary.stampingup.net. Thank you so much for joining me today. Today is day six of 7 days of Christmas. This project I'm bringing you today is a side fold card or a storybook card. Depends what you want to call it, but it opens like this. And it's got a cute little sort of fold on the side there, and you put your greeting in the inside. And I have used the Cottage Wreaths stamp set and the Country Wreath dies for this one. Now these are currently in our Stampin' Up mini catalogue. They are going to carry over and they are available as a bundle where you save 10%. So if you want to get them and save the 10%, do it before the 3rd or 4th of January next year. They'll still be available, but you have to purchase them singly, separately. So let me show you how I made this card. I'm using a base of mint macaron and shaded spruce. And this adorable gingham paper is from the same suite as the Gingham Cottage Designer Series paper. It's a whole massive big stack of 12 by 12 Designer Series paper, all in the gingham colours. I recommend you get it earlier rather than later because it's just so fabulous. It's a little piece of our gold glimmer paper that I've used there to cut out the bow, which is also in this set. So let's go ahead and make it. I've put all the descriptions and all the cutting and scoring in the description bar below, but this base will measures 11 inches by 4 1/4, and we're going to go ahead and do two score marks on this one. We're going to score it at 4 1/2 and again at 5 1/2. And then, we're just going to score it. I just think I moved the video camera down, so okay. Score it there. I'm just going to grab my scoring blade. Sorry, my bone folder. And then all we're going to do is simply fold back on that other score line that we've made. So that one right there. I'm just going to fold that one back on itself. Give it a good burnish, and then that becomes our little fold. It's our storybook fold. Cute, right? I really like it. I think it's a really cute way to, really cute little fold. And let's adhere that down now. And then I've got a piece of thick basic white to go on the inside. That measures 4 1/4 by 4. I'll just use the Tombow because I seem to not have anything else at hand right now. Let's put that in there. So your sentiment would go right about there. So I've gone ahead with the shaded spruce and cut that one. That's 4 1/4 by 4. And then this one is just 4 by 3 3 1/4, I should say. That's one side of the Designer Series paper. And then that's the other side, which we're going to use there. You might as well put that one down now. So it's got the bigger check on one side and then the smaller check on the other. Come out, there we go. So just position that out there so it's straight. It's not easy to see the same color Designer Series paper on the cardstock, but it looks about right. Alright, so this beautiful die is this beautiful stamp here, the wreath stamp. So we're going to stamp that in shaded spruce. Now, it almost looks like I've done two-step stamping there, doesn't it, with the second layer of the lighter shade, but that's actually built into the stamp. I just love the way that looks. I really love it. Okay, so as you'll see, with the shaded spruce, and it comes out, it just comes out in the two layers there. Such a clever idea. We're going to cut that out now in our using our Big Shot. So I'm just grab a stamp and cut and emboss machine. We'll just grab that and run that through. Alright, so I've been through, stamped that, die cut that. I'm going to put a little bit of stamping around the outside here with the berries. One trick when you're cutting this out, I did forget to show, is that when you cut it out, I usually line up the inside here, pieces here. So I know it sounds strange, but when you cut it out, before you put the die in, I usually go like, I know there's an easy way to do it, but what I do is I actually line up the inside pieces, which I'm not doing a very good job of showing you at the moment, but there we go. See that? There's a little notch right about there, if you can see it. I'm just using the inside as a guide, and that will line that up absolutely perfectly. So that's what I do. I don't try and do the outside. I go from that little notch on the inside. Put a little bit of washi tape on there if you wanted to, just as a little reminder. Here's a little bit of Poppy Parade to put our little berries on. This is the beautiful bow that's in the set. Look at that paper. It's a fabulous, fabulous bow. I love the way it's got all this detail in it when you cut it out. And on that glimmer paper, it looks so great. So let's put that in the one. I'm going to grab in my mini dimensionals and pop one on the back there. They just fit. Just fits. Might you just need to fold it down, just push that down just a little bit, just to get it all in, so you don't can't see it, because nobody wants to see a dimensional. Here we go. Now for the sentiment Merry Christmas, I've stamped that in Poppy Parade also. I didn't want it to be on the outside, I just wanted it to be in the inside. So what I've done is I've actually already stamped it on a small piece of basic white, and I'm just going to kind of get it positioned. So I've still got a little tail here at the end, and I'll cut that off in just a moment. So I'll just put a little bit of Tombow here on one edge, and then sort of eyeball the center there. Just working it so I can see. Oops, I want it to be more in the middle. That's right. There we go. It looks about right to me. Just give that a couple of seconds just to dry. And then just going to very carefully pull that back just as quick as I can and put a little bit of Tombow in there. And then hold it down. I'm sure there's an easy way to do it as well, but you know, I'll always find the harder way. So put that back and then trim that off. Okay. You could put it on dimensionals too, I guess. It's another option. It probably would have been easier, but oh well, it's done now. So yes, you could put dimensionals on there, I guess. Alright, so I'm just putting some dimensionals on here now, just to secure it. And put that over there, because we need to also pack this up here. Okay. Alright. So, just going to make sure I've got the wider side in here. Yes, that's correct. For the Tombow. Can use the other, the smaller gingham side of this if you want to. I just love that big gingham look. Love, love, love it. And just position that. It's a pretty easy card to make, and it's just a little bit different being a little bit of a cute little fun fold. And let's adhere it to the card. Just lining it up with the designer series paper down the side there. And bring back in the wreath, pop it in the middle. Oops, it's not straight. Now it is. And there you have it. And then to finish off, some of the real red rhinestones, which we've had going for quite a few years now. I tend to only really use them at Christmas time, which is kind of a shame because they're super pretty. And on to here. You could pop a couple on the wreath. Why don't we just do that? Just for a little bit of, why not? On there. There you go. And there you have it. A super easy side fold or storybook fold, whatever you like, card made with the Country Wreath dies and the Cottage Wreath stamp set. I hope you enjoyed that video, and if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. All the links for the products I've used today are in the description bar below. Thank you so much and have a great day. Bye.